One of the most frequently asked questions by many international applicants are schools in Norway
do they
require English proficiency? Is my country among or is my country exempted from the English text? And how do I find out which school? And how do I go about it? Yes, guys, most schools in Norway do not require English test from you, but it depends if your country is exempted or not. I am super excited today, guys, because I am going to answer, if not all of your questions, guys, but at least some of them in this video about English test and which school to check out. So let's dive right in and find out more. Please continue watching. English proficiency, English proficiency, English proficiency. This has really been a great challenge to most international student applicants. But you are at the right place. No more panic, guys, because before you finish watching this video to the end, which is like an edge to these frequently asked questions, you'll be able to find out one or two things that can help you know and how to go about this admission process. Basically, in matters that concern English test and which country is exempted. If your country is exempted or if it is required as one of the documentations for your admission process. Hey guys, welcome again to my channel. My name is Chidinma, and if we are meeting for the first time, welcome, welcome, and welcome. I am a master's student in Norway and I also live in Norway. So today, our topic is about 5 schools that do not require English proficiency in Norway. Yes, I know that there may be many schools that do not require English proficiency, but in this video, we are going to mention just 5 schools. Yes, 5 schools. 90% of the programs require English test scores proof with your English proficiency. There are a lot of master's degrees in Norway, such as Masters in Industrial Engineering, Masters in Chemistry, Masters in Language Studies, Masters in Business Administration, Masters in Mathematics, Masters in Management and Leadership, and so many, many Masters here in Norway. Norway has 7 accredited public universities, 9 accredited specialized universities institutions, 22 accredited university colleges, 2 accredited national colleges of arts, and several private institutions of higher education with either institutional or program accreditation. That's a lot, right, guys? So massive. Prepare to apply for a Norwegian university. Guys, wow. When preparing, also prepare your mind that Norway is super, super cold. So not to worry, guys. Cold is all about when you cover yourself properly and wear the right clothes for cold. It doesn't have any effect on you, isn't it? All jokes aside, the first step in preparation is researching. Researching is very necessary because it aids you to be more versatile with what you want and what you're doing. Considering the number of universities that you can pick from and that each has a list of study program and a distinct list of documents necessary for applying, you should check and consider all the criteria before choosing a degree. Norway has a website dedicated to international students who wish to enroll in an academic program within its border, where all the degrees are centralized and the specific details are neatly organized in tables. And this website is studyinnorway.no. In this website, you'll be able to find a list of schools in Norway, courses and their requirements, country requirements and any other related study criteria needed to study in Norway. Use that website as much as possible. It was meant to help students like you and I. Where to apply for a Norwegian master's degree? Norwegian universities, business schools, and other higher education institutions have their own application rules and criteria. And if you visit their websites, you'll find an entire list of Norwegian master degrees. If you click on it, you find the deadline, the requirements, which will take you to the university page where you find the official application process. Now, here brings us to the main topic for our today's video. Guys, you know that since we have been talking about the Norwegian website for international students, which is studyinnorway.no, and how you can go about it, the courses, criteria of studies, the requirements, and even more things that are related to studies that can enable and guide you properly on the journey of application to study in Norway. Now, we are going to talk about only 5 schools that do not require English proficiency. Yes, there may be more schools that do not require this English proficiency, but we are only going to talk about just 5 schools in today's video. Language requirement for a Norwegian university application. There are schools that require English proficiency, while the good news is that some schools as well do not require English proficiency. The list of English proficiency is as follows: TOEFL IBT, IELTS Academic, CI Advanced, PTE Academic. And to avoid encountering problems during official application, you should always check which English language test is accepted by the university and what grade you need to be accepted in. That is for schools that include English proficiency tests as one of their requirements. So let's dive straight in. These are a list of 5 schools that you do not require English proficiency. First, University of Bergen, University of Stavanger, University of Agder, University of Tromsø, and Oslo Metropolitan University. So in each of these universities, I'll be mentioning 4 to 5 different courses that do not require English proficiency tests. Please note that most of the courses as well in some of these universities that I mentioned may require English proficiency, but I was able to find 4 to 5 different courses that do not require English proficiency test for Nigerian international applicants. So I'm going to start with the first one that I mentioned, which is University of Bergen, and the 4 courses that I was able to find that do not require English proficiency test for Nigerian international applicants. So for University of Bergen, I was able to find 3 courses. The first one is Biomedical Science, Public Administration, and Linguistic Masters. On the page, you'll see how to apply. Ensure to follow the link to find the general entry requirements and guidelines on how to apply. You'll see columns like for citizens from outside European Union, citizens for within European Union, Nordic citizens and applicants residing in Norway, and you also see the deadline of each of them, when the admission will start and when the admission will end. So for an international person applying, you have to choose the column for person outside European Union, and the admission portal will open by 1st of November and the deadline will be by December 1st, 2021. Admission requirements. Under the admission requirement, you find out where it is listed about competence of the English language must be demonstrated by obtaining an adequate score for TOEFL or IELTS tests or an equivalent qualification. You also see the list of countries outlined alphabetically. Ensure to select your own country, Nigeria, for example. The country list, the educational requirements for admissions for master's degrees at the University of Bergen. There you will see the requirements suitable for the course you want to apply. Then you also see a place where they wrote English test results, boldly written no. That is for Nigerian international applicants in the country list. You are responsible to provide the additional requirement for your application process. So guys, the good news is that these 4 courses that are mentioned in Bergen University, they do not require English proficiency test for applicants, for students applicants in Nigeria. So let's talk about the University of Agder and their English proficiency test. From the findings from the University of Agder, most countries are exempted from the English language proficiency test, which Nigeria is also one of them. So I'm going to talk about 4 to 5 different courses that I found out that do not require English language proficiency in the University of Agder. It's English Masters, followed by International Business, then Mathematics, Global Development Studies, and information communication technology. You know that there may be more courses there that have exemption, especially Nigeria in the country league section and other countries as well. But these are specifically talking about Nigerian international students applicants. So in the page of University of Adda, you search for admission requirements. The admission will be starting on the 1st of November and the deadline is 1st of December 2021. Please also note that you have to familiarize yourself with every information so that you can follow up with their procedures. And if there is change of any information, you are responsible to familiarize yourself with their page and keep yourself updated of any information at all. So in the same page, you can head up to how to apply for degree programs. And there are different requirements depending on which country you come from and your educational background. So if you're from Nigeria, you can select Nigeria and ensure that you read the requirements for the admission process. You also see there language requirements, which says that if you are an applicant from Nigeria, you are exempted from the English language requirement listed. University of Tromsø. So the list of courses that was able to research on are Applied Science Master, Public Health, Electrical Engineering, English Literature, Industrial Engineering. So I was able to pick up 5 in the University of Tromsø. From the 5 above mentioned courses from the University of Tromsø, Nigerian international applicants are exempted from English language proficiency. Yes, there may be more list of courses that Nigeria may be exempted from the English proficiency test as well. But as I said earlier, I am only listing 4 or 5 in each of the schools I mentioned before now. As an international applicant, ensure to search their website properly and go to the admission requirements to find out the basics of the admission that you're about to apply for and the areas of certifications needed to see if you are qualified to apply for any particular course you choose. And also ensure to familiarize yourself with their page to ensure easier understanding and to avoid mistakes while applying. Be sure to check out the requirements for applicants outside EU. From there, it will direct you to the country list where you will see all countries listed alphabetically to find your own country and their requirements if your country is exempted from the English proficiency test or if your country is required to write the English proficiency before you proceed to the admission. Finally, for the University of Tromsø, all the 5 courses that I mentioned, Nigeria is also exempted. OsloMet. OsloMet, also known as Oslo Metropolitan University. So for the list of Oslo Metropolitan University, I was able to find 4 courses that Nigeria is exempted from English proficiency test. Yes, as I always have said before, that they may also have more courses that Nigeria may be exempted from or other courses that require Nigeria to have English proficiency. But I was able to find only 4 courses for this. So the courses that I found about Oslo Metropolitan are, the first one is International Social Welfare and Health Policy, Applied Computer and Information Technology, International Education and Development, Public Health Nutrition, Masters in Health Sciences, and Structural Engineering and Building Technology. In their page, you can select any course of your choice and you'll be directed to their website, which you will find any information regarding the particular course that you selected. There you also see the admission requirements and you can find the proof of English language proficiency for masters. If you're applying for an international master degree, you have to document your English proficiency. This also depend on your country, if your country is exempted or not. And you do not need to take any English proficiency test if your country is included on the countries that are exempted that have English as their native language. And also in their list, Nigeria is also included as one of the countries that do not require English proficiency for the courses that I mentioned before. So guys, the final, so the last but not the least university on my list, which is University of Stavanger. In University of Stavanger, I was able to find three courses that Nigeria is also among the countries that were exempted in the English language proficiency. So the courses are as follows. So the first is Masters of Science and Business Administration, followed by Masters in English and Literacy Studies, and the last, which is Masters of Science, Mathematics and Physics. I also checked out their country list, and Nigeria, absolutely as usual, is also among the countries that were also exempted. So Nigerian international applicants do not require English proficiency for the courses I mentioned. Please kindly note that there may be courses, more courses that Nigerian applicants do not, but I was only able to find these three courses. Also note that there may also be courses Nigerian applicants are required to have the English proficiency. That is why I say it is good for you to familiarize yourself with the website, the international student website, which is studyinnorway.no, to know if your country is exempted or not. This video is just to give you an edge on how you can follow up your admission process. Guys, in as much as these schools that I mentioned above do not require English test for Nigerian international applicants, I also ensured that I checked out at least 4 to 5 courses in each of the schools that I mentioned, just to be very sure that they do not require English proficiency for Nigerian international applicants. But however, most courses in these schools do not require English proficiency for Nigerian applicants. You can also, of course, visit the website and also ensure if your country is exempted or if your country is required to have the English proficiency test for the admission process. So guys, this brings us to the end of today's video. Please, it may also interest you to check out my previous videos by the title, Can You Work in Norway with Your Nigerian Certificate? And the second one, which is How to Join Your Student Husband or Wife in Norway. And if you enjoyed watching, kindly subscribe to my YouTube channel, like and comment. Please always feel free to ask questions pertaining the possibilities in Norway, and I will try as much as possible to answer the ones that I can. And also, I'll be leaving my Instagram handle on the screen. You can also follow me up on Instagram for more questions. Thank you for always watching, and I'll also leave the links to my previous videos in the description box below. And thank you as always for watching. Bye bye.